Okay, in this video we're just going to do these three examples. We'll round each number and then we'll estimate the product. So we're going to round 868. Now you probably want to round that to the nearest 100, right? So round 868 and what do you get? It's approximately 900, okay? Round 13. What do you get if you round 13? Once again, the number after the 8 is a 6. That's why we rounded up to get 9 here, right? 900. So the number after you'd round this guy to the nearest 10, basically, right? So the number after that is a 3, so you round down to 10, right? So if the number is 5 or more, if the next digit is 5 or more, we round up. If it's 4 or less, we round down. Remember that? So now we have 900 times 10. So what's the answer? Well, let's think of it this way. This is $900. Okay, $900. What happens if you've got 10 of those? 10 900s. Each plane ticket costs $900. How much would 10 of those plane tickets cost? Well, it would be 9,000, wouldn't it? And one way of doing it is, look, 1 times 9 is 9, and we've got 1, 2, 3 zeros. Okay? So the answer would be 9,000. So you basically add on the 1, 2, 3 zeros, and you get that. Now, that's a kind of a handy way to estimate this, and if you were to multiply it out, it should be something close to 9,000 anyway. So let's estimate this guy. 732 times 17. 732 is approximately what? And again, you could round that to the nearest 100, right? So the next digit after the 7 is 3, so you're going to round up or down?
Round
down to 700, okay? And then we have 17. The next digit after the 10 is a 7, so would you round that guy up or down? You'd round it down, up, wouldn't it, to 20, okay? Now, 700 times 20 is what we have now. That's a little bit handier. And you would go 2 times 7. What's 2 times 7? Is 14. And how many zeros do we have? 1, 2, 3. So you just go 1, 2, 3. See that? 20 times 700, 14,000. And that's the answer. Should have put a comma here too. Okay. So that's the handy way to do these, and it's kind of useful if you're looking at big numbers and you just want to get a quick estimate in your head. It's a very useful skill. So 9,999, can you round that to the nearest 1,000? 9,999 to the nearest 1,000. And remember, 1,000 doesn't just have to be something that has one digit here. Like, let me show you this. 120,000 is a multiple of 1,000 simply because it has 3 zeros at the end of it. It's 120,000. So, whatever happens, this number has to have 3 digits at the end. It doesn't matter what happens after that. Just as long as it's 3 digits at the end, it is rounded to the 1,000. So, how would you round this guy to the 1,000? You've got a 9 as the next digit after the 1,000 is a 9, then we've got another 9, so we round up, and that becomes 10. 10,000 is a multiple of 1,000 because it has 3 zeros at the end of it, so that's 10,000, right? Then we have round this guy to the nearest 100. What would that be? You've got a 7 and then a 100 spot and then a 7 after it. So would you round that up or down? You'd round it up to 800, right? So then we multiply these guys. And seriously, all you've got to do is 8 times 1. What's 8 times 1? 8. And then write in how many zeros we have in the problem. 1, 2, 3, 4. Because that would be 8,000. See, there's 8. Or that would be, 80,000. 8 times that. But then times 100... these two zeros gives you two more. Okay, and then what do you end up with? You go 1, 2, 3, comma, 1, 2, 3, comma. And that is what?
What's that number?
6 zeros on the end of it. That is 8 million. 8 million.